And now, coming up on Patreon is the 10-minute Heartbreaker remix. Let's go. It's so exciting, like I sort of know what I'm in for, but then I've got no idea. Already, the way he's building that track, that bass sound, that drum. Loving the low register again. Sounds great. It's another classic, yeah. That's a great sound. It's big synth stabs with that piano doing the same thing. Here we go. Great backing vocals. Are they by her backing singers, not by her? I've made that mistake before. Oh, this is great. Something just happened there that was like... It's just that. Okay. Have any of you actually heard this in a club and just absolutely lost it? I can't imagine. It would sound amazing, obviously. Crazy vocals there. Let's have a big finish. This is great. I've never heard a voice that sounds like this. Ever. It's so great.
I love you. Game on me.
Okay. I thought that was going to be one of those David Morales mixes, but it's Junior Vasquez. I've heard of that person or that artist, but I don't know anything about them, obviously. What I loved about that, apart from everything, like how it sounds, the vocals, the instrumentation, just everything about the sound of it, is that the structure of that allows her to get so deep into the emotion of it. Like, it's 10 minutes long for a reason, right? To keep you on the dance floor, keep you dancing, you know. I get that that's why you get extended mixes of stuff, to kind of keep you up there for longer. But what this allows her to do is, for 10 minutes, just go deep into her soul, like have a dark night of the soul, talking about all her emotions about having a heartbroken, but not talking about it, singing about it, repeating bits over and over again, different ways of vocalizing certain bits. It was just stunning, absolutely stunning. While the track was playing and I was looking at the lyrics, I was trying to think of some best bits to come back to. I lost count, there were just too many good ones. So in a second, we'll go back and just pick some random bits, see what we can find, because it was all so, so good. Such high quality stuff, that was just amazing. And I love the passion and power of Mariah's voice and how she can layer it, but also the backing vocals from Marianne Tatum and Melanie Daniels, it says here. They're her regular backing vocalists, aren't they? They are so good, so good. Anyway, I don't think this stuff is really made to be talked about. Let's have a listen again. Okay, so we're looking for great vocals. First few minutes we had that lower register, kind of nasal sounding but in a good way. Yeah, a bit before that was good too, I think. Yeah. That was cool. This is just as good as any of the other ones I've heard, of the Morales ones. Obviously a lot of that's down to Mariah, but, you know, it's her thing. Oh yeah. Power. Belting those notes out. Ah, that, yeah, that was a good one. I remember that. It's so great. What I mean about the emotional core of it. Instead of doing it in a pop song, she gets this thing, why did you run your game on me? You know? It does let her get more, like, ring more emotional at every word. Listen to that, man. It's got the best of me. That's not just for the clubs to sound cool. That is for her to exercise those demons, I think. I know it needs to be 10 minutes long, but... And then you get the whistle. It's so, so great. Love it.